I hear the word cultural village alarm bells go off, the term usually applies to a series of themed souvenir shops linked by a video presentation conducted by an actor in traditional headgear and a grass skirt. But already this looks more promising. This is apparently prehistoric Borneo, as it once was. Mari Mari Cultural Village is about half an hour outside Kota Kinabalu, the capital of Malaysia's Sabah on the island of Borneo. This isn't a show-up-and-look-around kind of place. It's a choreographed interactive show that must be booked. The village showcases five major ethnic groups of northern Borneo. To get the party started, my guide, Shafiq, pours me a tipple of the local rice wine.
What does it taste like? It tastes like whiskey?
Yeah, it tastes like whiskey. So you can have a taste here. And there's a cheer for the dusun. They say it like this, aramaiti.
Aramaiti.
Yeah, aramaiti means together. So, aramaiti. Yes. There you go.
So wow, that's taste? Really pleasant. Line them up.
This house is home to the Bajau, who were sea gypsies and created another use for rice with their fishnet cookies.
Every show turns into a cooking show at some point, doesn't it?
Yes.
These days. And across here?
Yeah. Rotate it. Slowly, slowly. And the other way around. And then, second.
Oh, perfect.
Yes.
Yeah, it's really light, isn't it? It's kind of like a thousand things to do with rice.
While the village has been carved out of the jungle for the tourists, it is heartening to know that it was built by the descendants of the tribes they represent. And everyone working here is the real deal.
And so the rulers' tribe were obviously farmers.
Yes.
Agriculture was their specialty.
And hunting as well.
And hunting.
Yes. Hunting, beads making.
And just as you are feeling the serenity of time gone by, the last house looms.
Right, these are the headhunters.
Yes, so they're going to check you first whether you bring any weapon with you or not. He's asking, are you the leader?
I am the leader. There's no doubt about it.
Okay.
I don't stand here.
Okay, you need to put your right hand on his shoulder and turn facing
each other.
How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Siapa nama aku?
What is your name?
David.
Dari mana aku, David?
Where are you from, David?
Australia.
Australia. Buat apa kau datang kampung saya?
What are you doing inside my village?
I've come to visit.
The Murut were the famously feared headhunting tribe, and their weapon of choice was the blowpipe.
This is an example of the dart. And normally they put the poison right here at the tip. And the poison didn't come from any venomous snakes or frogs or any kind of animals, but it actually came from a tree. We call it ipo tree or ipo tree. So the sap of the tree is very poisonous, where if you get shot by it, the heart will stop, slowly stop in 5 minutes. Yeah, and there's no known cure for that.
Slowly stop in 5 minutes?
Yeah, in a few minutes.
I hate to see what you think of fast.
With poisonous darts flying through the jungle, the Murut came up with a way to keep the kids entertained inside the safety of their own house. And the big kids created their own skill tests using it too.
This is so refreshingly different to most cultural villages I've experienced. It's really good, it's authentic, it's informative, it's inclusive. It's a great example of a people who were clearly into the finer things in life, food, drink, stimulants, the odd severed head or two. There's every chance you'll leave here yearning for the simpler life.
As much as a night in the jungle might be enticing, you can't stay at Mari Mari, but back in Kota Kinabalu, the starting point for any trip to Sabah, the Hilton, is filled with plenty more smiling faces. The Hilton definitely sets the tone with its breakfast buffet, which starts your day with a crash course in Asian cuisine. The rooms are everything you need in a five-star establishment, with a choice of shower or bath to cleanse away the day's humidity. And the rooftop pool deck means there is always a breeze to dial the heat down a notch or two.